I now lay a bleeding witness of the necessity imposed on our sex to gather the first honey off the thorns. But the pleasure rising as the pain subsided, I was soon reconciled to fresh trials, and before morning nothing on earth could be dearer to me than this rifler of my virgin sweets. He was everything to me now. How we agreed to join fortunes, how we came up to town together, where we lived some time, till necessity parted us, and drove me into this course of life in which I had been long ago battered and torn to pieces before I came to this age, as much through my easiness as through my inclination, had it not been for my finding refuge in this house. These are all circumstances which pass the mark I proposed, so that here my narrative ends. In the order of our sitting, it was Harriet's turn to go on. Amongst all the beauties of our sex that I had before or have since seen, few indeed were the forms that could dispute excellence with hers. It was not delicate, but delicacy itself incarnate. Such was the symmetry of her small but exactly fashioned limbs. Her complexion, fair as it was, appeared yet more fair from the effect of two black eyes, the brilliancy of which gave her face more vivacity than belonged to the colour of it, which was only defended from paleness by a sweetly pleasing blush in her cheeks, that grew fainter and fainter, till at length it died away insensibly into the overbearing white. Then her miniature features joined to finish the extreme sweetness of it, which was not belied by that of temper turned to indolence, languor, and the pleasures of love. Pressed to subscribe her contingent, she smiled, blushed a little, and thus complied with our desires.